Look at these expertly crafted handbags. More than 40 years ago, by making such vogue handbags, Dongguan, a city in China's Guangdong province, opened its door toward export-oriented economy and embarked on the road of reform and opening up. Well, what exactly is the history behind these handbags? Now I'm here at the Taiping Handbags Factory Exhibition Hall. Please join me and have a look.
当时 1978年, 那广商张子谜先生来到了我们广东, 就是跟我们的太平服装厂去合作, 就开办这个太平手袋厂。 他说当时是考虑到这里的交通比较方便, 我们当时的合作模式就是三来一补, 我们主要是 负责劳动力的提供, 然后呢, 原材料啊, 技术啊, 设备啊, 都是他们的, 然后我们就是收取, 收取那个加工费。
The 3 plus 1, a tentative pattern of enterprise cooperation prevalent in the early days of reform and opening up in Guangdong, includes processing supplied materials and samples, assembling with provided parts, and composition trade. Relying on this model, Dongguan's manufacturing industry developed rapidly, and countless products have flowed to all of the world from here. As one of the first working in the handbag factory, Chen Weifen shares her memories about the bygone days.
香港的工人呢就教我们抽做这个衣车，我们本来没有车这种衣车的嘛，我们几个人都学会了，就他就大批招人就。 教他们怎样车了。那时候呢，没有多劳多得。那时候呢，就是8小时嘛，你不用什么运物的，就是你车来车上班，就是这个工资32块嘛。后来呢，多劳多得了，全部你车多少就有多少了。那些工人呢，基本都差不多上100块，发梦都没有发这样挣这么多钱的。那时候
，in just a few years, Taiping Handbags Factory became the most profitable one in Hunan, with nearly 1,000 workers at its peak, including some 300 migrant workers from its neighboring Jiangxi province. Some self-owned brands were also established at the same time.
Taiping手袋厂呢，就是中国对外加工第一家，就是需要勇气和胆量的。那么他这种敢为人先、先行先试的这个精神呢，就对我们当下，还是很有启发作用的。